Very slightly over 11 miles northwest of Nottingham lies the ruinous Annesley Hall. I went to see what is left of All Saints Church, which is to be seen on a raised hillock to the northeast of the remains of the hall. The church was built by the incumbent Annesley family, who were the hall's owners in about 1356. It's on the site of a previous building. In spite of the new church being built a mile or so away nearer to the Pitt village in 1874, some reduced services were being held here until the early 1940s. The buildings didn't fare too badly until the hall was sold in 1973, when the rot was allowed to do its worst. The church roof is long gone, as are the internal fittings. Now open to the atmosphere, it is, however, still well worth an easily accessible walk around the walls and floor plan of the one-time place of worship in order to drink in the history of the site. This monument tells a tragic tale of the Blockley family, who, having lost their four-year-old daughter in April of 1872, were to lose their four-month-old daughter only 2 months later. All of the internal monuments have been moved to the new church. For what it's worth, the church is a Grade 1 listed building. The name Annesley is of English origin, meaning a clearing with a hermitage. A much better insight of the remaining monuments and furniture is to be had by reading the signage, which is liberally spread around the grounds of the church, as you walk around drinking in the atmosphere. Annesley Hall, which is in private ownership, dates from the mid-13th century, but was much added to in the 17th and 19th centuries. It was originally the home of the Annesley family and then the Charworth Musters family, Emily Charworth being the childhood crush of Lord Byron. Unfortunately, it became derelict after the family moved to Felly Priory during the 1970s. At the time of writing, January 2021, the hall is a definite no-go area for members of the public, and a very active security guard will inform you of this fact. Very obviously, it is still a local site of extreme interest. Often the small church car park will be filled to capacity and beyond. People walk their dogs here and are drawn to the handsome but sadly neglected extraordinary house. Although in spite of receiving many grants, the hall is still in a massive state of disrepair, not helped in any way by the two large fires which have plagued the hall. One in 1997, which ended its tenure as a residential family home, and one in 2015. Ah. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this. If you did, please consider subscribing to the channel and feel free to check out the other videos. My next planned outing will be the Oakwell Brickworks, also in Ilkeston. So until then, stay safe.